The Bob Cummings Show.
Hold it. I think you're going to like this picture.
Everybody likes Winston. Winston is America's best-selling, best-tasting filter cigarette with the bright, clear flavor of fine tobacco. You'll enjoy Winston, and you'll enjoy The Bob Cummings Show.
Hey, Mom. Hey, listen to this. An Air Force Globemaster will touch down at Van Nuys Air Base today carrying what is perhaps the most beautiful cargo ever assembled. 53 beauty queens representing United States air bases throughout the world. One of these lovely contestants will be crowned Queen of the Air by a Hollywood judge as yet unannounced.
Uncle Bob!
What an assignment, judging a beauty contest. Say, I wonder if Uncle Bob's expecting to get it.
Oh, good morning.
Yes?
I beg your pardon?
I said yes, it's a good morning.
Oh, yes, good morning.
Why the uniform?
Well, I'm expecting an assignment today, Margaret.
Well, what do you suppose it'll be, Uncle Bob?
Chuck, when you're in the Air Force, you don't speculate. You just do what they ask you to do, no matter how dangerous it may be.
Oh, Bob, don't let them make you do anything dangerous.
Oh, Margaret, whatever it is, I'm ready. If they ask me to test a rocket, I'll test it. Ask me to fly an experimental plane, I'll fly it.
If they ask you to judge a beauty contest, you'll judge it.
You bet. You know about this, huh?
You bet.
Don't keep a military secret in this house.
Bob, you will wear a parachute, carry plenty of oxygen.
Huh? Uncle Bob, can I go along and share some of the danger?
No, Chuck, there may be some real danger with this operation. I mean, those girls may be wearing experimental bathing suits.
These are the worst eggs yet.
You're eating them.
Not these, the ones you and your comic son are laying.
Oh, all kidding aside, Uncle Bob, can I come to the studio?
No, you can't.
But gee, yesterday when you photographed Peter Lawford, you invited Mom and her whole bridge
Chuck,
club.
I would hardly call that surprise invasion by your mother and her middle-aged commandos an invitation. You should see the look on Peter Lawford's face when that group of Slenderella rejects poured in. Those are the only women that I know can stretch a three-way girdle four ways. But you still can't go to the studio.
Mom. Mom, did you hear the terrible things he said about...
Sit down. Benedict Arnold. Back, girls, back. You're steaming up the picture. How do they call that beautiful hunk of man sin?
Kind of makes you want to throw rocks at your boyfriend, huh, Martha?
Okay, girls, as I promised you, your own personal photograph of Peter Lawford. Compliments of the boss, but don't tell him.
What a dream.
Hey, mine's different.
Oh, well, that's the one the boss snapped when Margaret's bridge club came barging in.
Thanks, honey. Oh. Hey, Schulze, a picture is one thing, but just between us girls, what does Peter Lawford look like in person?
Yeah. Well, he's just a plain, average, everyday, run-of-the-mill Greek god.
Mm. Oh, what a job you've got, Schulze. Imagine being in the same studio with him.
He is gorgeous, isn't he?
Mm. Oh, what did you just run my fingers through his hair?
Hello. Oh. Well, how nice to see all of you. What a surprise.
They were just leaving, boss.
Oh, no need to leave.
I gave each one of them a picture. I hope you don't mind.
Of course not, Schulze. It's deductible.
Would you like an autograph?
Oh, would you do
would
that,
you
Roy?
Peter Lawford?
Could you get my autograph?
What's the idea of giving away expensive photographs?
It's deductible.
Yes, from your salary. Now look, this is a business office, so clear out, all of you. Now! Stay out! You didn't hear me.
I want to talk to you about my boyfriend.
Well, I don't want to talk to you.
Oh, you tango divine!
Schultze, I don't know if it's occurred to you, but there's going to come a time when there won't be.
Bob Collins Photography. Yes, sir. Just a moment, sir.
Now, listen.
It's General Batterson, for you.
If... Yeah? He's in charge of the Air Force bathing beauty contest. Yes? Colonel Collins here. Oh, yes, General. Yes, I intend to be in all day, sir. An assignment, sir? Well, sir, I have no idea what you intend to ask me to do, but whatever it is, I stand ready to do it, sir. Well, thank you, General Bathing Suit.
Cigarette is more than welcome, if it's the one that tastes good like a cigarette should. Because there's more to a Winston than just the pure white filter. Winston's got filter blend, up front, up ahead of the filter. Fine, mild tobacco, specially processed for filter smoking. Filter blend is a mighty good reason for you to be smoking Winston, America's best-selling filter cigarette.
Schulte, this is no laughing matter. Now, I really want to impress General Batterson. Doggone it, haven't we any prettier models than these?
Well, I can try for Miss Universe.
Miss Universe?
And now it's me, Martha. Anyway, doll.
Martha, I thought I told you.
Now, Mr. Collins, look, this is business. I want you to take pictures of my boyfriend like you do Peter Law.
I haven't got time, Martha.
But this is business. He's a very big star.
I don't get it.
Hey, Ross!
Listen, are you the fellow that's going to take my picture for nothing?
He does an imitation of Edward G. Robinson.
Let me... Who doesn't?
All right, you guys.
Roscoe, take off the glasses.
Oh.
He really doesn't need them. He only uses them for effect.
I'm the boss around here, see? You take orders from me, see? That's right, see? I'm getting seasick here. Kid, you stick with me, I'll put a gold spoon right in your kisser. That's right, yeah, sure, yeah. How's that, Mr. Collins? Oh, Mr. Collins.
I'll go along with that. Now, you go along with Roscoe.
Taggy.
Wait a minute, kid. Wait just a minute, kid. Wait, don't touch me, you dirty rat. There's a rod I got in my pocket. It'll be curtains for you. It's a curtain rod.
Hasn't Roscoe got it?
He sure has. Now, get him out of here before one of us gets.
Well, what about the pictures? You know, you can shoot him in all his different characters.
Everything.
It would be a pleasure, but I don't have a gun. Schultze.
Did you get the information, Mr. Collins?
Schultze, if...
We need new blood.
Go to get it! Schultze, unless you have a friend at the unemployment office whom you wish to visit regularly each week, don't let any more weirdies in here!
Schultz, running or running? I'm hoping to lure that handsome boss of yours to the beach with me.
Oh, not a chance, Pam. He's got a very busy schedule.
I am prepared to overcome his resistance with woman's oldest weapon, S-E-X. Underneath this trench coat, I am wearing nothing but a bathing suit.
Look, the boss is expecting a 3-star general from Washington. He's got no time to bother.
Schultz! Let loose of the general! Schultz, you really are. Oh, Pamela, I'm...
Come with me, my bronze beach boy. Let us away where fishes play.
Pamela, really, I can't go with you where fishes play. Can't you find somebody else?
Well, who?
Yeah. Schultz, could you find somebody to go to the beach with Pamela?
Okay, how's Peter Lawford?
That's a good...
Mr. Lawford and I were an item once.
You and Peter Lawford.
Oh, Schultz,
were
don't get her started. You and Peter Lawford?
Yes. You see, I was working in the stenographic pool at his studio. One day he needed somebody to retype an entire script. Mm-hmm. He took one look at my flying fingers and chose me. Mm-hmm. We worked in his dressing room. Quite late and quite alone. His father was furious.
Yours or his?
But would you believe this, Mr. Collins? Not once did he get fresh with me.
I believe it. Well, see you, Pamela. Pamela, really, I'm so busy. Please understand. So busy. Just understand. Schulte!
Pamela, wait a minute.
Schulte! Pamela, now listen to me.
Collins.
Yes?
You have forced me to play my trump card.
Pamela.
You're shy.
Well, you're shy quite a little yourself.
But if my feminine charms prove too heady a wine, think of fish.
Yes, yes, I can see how that would be appropriate. I mean, yeah.
Mr. Collins, I have just come from Santa Monica.
Ah. Uh-huh.
The Grunion are running.
I mean, you saw them, did you?
No, but tonight, when the full moon casts a silver shadow...
Pamela, now let...
...across the rippling tide...
Wait a minute.
They'll be there, Mr. Collins.
Let's... Pamela.
And so will we.
Pamela. Listen to me, Pamela. Wait a minute. I'm frankly not interested in Grunion.
Frankly? Neither am I.
Pamela, wait.
General Batterson's in there.
Batterson. Now, Pamela, listen to me. This is very important. Schulte, handle this.
Now, wait.
Well, how nice to see you again, General.
Hello,
Batterson. Excuse me, this is my assistant, Miss Schulte.
Oh, yes, we've met.
Well, I'll get right to the point. Now, as you know, the Air Force is conducting a beauty contest. What we need now is a really competent judge.
Well, yes, sir, I can see how you would.
And, as my wife so aptly put it, what better authority on beauty than a man who has worked with the most beautiful girls in Hollywood?
Well, that is true, sir.
Now, when there's a man who combines that qualification with charm, good looks, and personality, well, he's ideal.
Well...
So, your assignment is to ask Peter Lawford to judge our contest.
Peter Lawford, sir?
Yes, my wife read somewhere that you had photographed him, so she felt that you'd have a personal contact with him.
With Peter Lawford?
You seem surprised.
No, sir. It's just the amazing coincidence of the whole thing, you see.
Coincidence?
Yes. In my studio at this very moment, there happens to be a bathing beauty whom Peter Lawford picked out of the big pool at MGM.
Really?
Could I see her?
I think you should. Yes. Excuse me just a moment, sir. Pamela, would you step in here for just a moment, please?
Hey, Collins. Mm-hmm. I'll bet she's...
The one filter cigarette that tastes good, like a cigarette should. There's more to a Winston, you know, than just a pure white filter. Winston's got filter blend up front, up ahead of the filter. Rich, flavorful tobacco, specially processed for filter smoking. Filter blend is a mighty good reason for you to be smoking Winston, America's best-selling filter cigarette.
I feel that you're somewhat shocked by my attire. Let me explain.
Oh, Pamela, I've already explained to the General about the bathing suit. Right, General?
Right, yes.
But not what's in it.
Yes, Pamela, would you like to tell the General now about how Peter Lawford picked you out of all those girls at MGM?
There were 38 of us in the pool.
And he picked you?
Indeed, he did. Later, when we were alone in his dressing room, he told me that I was his choice by a wide, wide margin.
Well, fine. Thank you so much, Pamela. Now, would you just kindly wait in the studio, please?
Au revoir, mon général.
Oh, yeah.
Well, what do you think, sir?
Peter Lawford picked her out of 38 girls.
Yes, sir. I must confess, she's not exactly my idea of feminine pulchritude either, sir. But it's, you know the old saying, well, one man's meat.
Well, I didn't even see any.
Is... Well, it's just a difference of opinion. You know, that's what makes a horse race.
Well, this happens to be a beauty contest. Yes, and sir. The winner is to represent the Air Force.
That ought to give the Navy a few chuckles, eh, sir? Would you get Peter Lawford on the phone for me, please?
Now, No, just a minute, please. Now, look, there must be some other man out here more qualified to judge beauty.
Hello, Mr. Collins.
Oh, yes, hello, Harriet. You can go right on in and get started.
Yes, sir.
you were saying, sir?
What? Oh, well, now there is real beauty.
Yes.
That model of yours.
Model? Harriet? Oh, hardly, sir.
Well, what is she then?
My cleaning woman.
Wow.
I only choose very, very pretty girls for models.
Collins, you know, if I had my way, you'd judge this beauty contest.
Really? Well, I have had some experience.
Of course, my wife's got her heart set on Peter Lawford.
Well, sir, suppose you just tell your wife that you've decided otherwise.
Collins, you're single, aren't you?
Yes, sir. I mean, yes, sir. What would you say if I spoke to your wife, sir?
Would you?
I'd be glad to.
I'll have her drop by.
Oh, thank you, sir. Yes, indeed. Goodbye, General.
Goodbye.
Cleaning woman?
Oh, yes, sir.
I wonder if she'd be interested in...
Nah, Florence would never go for it.
Now to get rid of that grunion hunter.
Mr. Collins, Roscoe's got a new one for you. Spencer Tracy. No, this will absolutely gas you.
Well, I feel a little nauseous already.
You gonna take a picture?
I'm going to. If you can pass the test.
Test?
Yes. Inside is a girl in a bathing suit. Oh, see if you can scare her into leaving.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Wow.
The General's wife is here.
Is she the type I figured?
Just like you said, Marilyn Monroe's double.
Twice her weight and twice her age, huh?
Send her in, but don't announce her. No matter how wild I get, no matter what I do, just play straight. You understand?
Anything for you, Bob.
Later, later.
No. For heaven's sake. Look, I want you to be seductive. Why... Show me some cheesecake. I said cheesecake! That's a breadstick!
What was the matter with this agency of yours? I tell them to send me a voluptuous woman, they send me a skinny, immature kid. Schulze, would you call the agency, please, and tell them to send over another... Oh, I see she already has. Good. Get the showers, Bones. Had a real model takeover. Oh, and when you see that boss of yours again, tell him when I ask for a voluptuous woman, this is what I mean. Right. You go on now and show her how to fill out that negligee.
Just a moment.
Oh, now, what's the matter? You don't want to pose in a negligee?
Certainly not.
Oh, great. Now I've got temperament. You top-flight models are all alike. At first, you'll pose for anything. Then you get into the big money. Then you become very proper and very modest. All you want to show is your beautiful face. Well, let me tell you something, baby. When you've got as much as you've got, share it!
Mr. Collins, I'm not a model.
What?
I'm Florence Batterson.
Listen, don't... No. No. Not General Batterson. Oh, I could kill myself.
Oh, now, it was a perfectly natural mistake.
I've insulted General Batterson's daughter.
Daughter, my dear boy, I'm the general's wife.
No.
a number of years.
Batterson, can you never forgive me?
Florence. And yes.
You'll never tell the general what I've done. He's so influential in the Air Force, and I'm just...
I can promise you it won't hurt you one bit in the Air Force.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Florence.
Goodbye, Mr. Collins. I'm very sorry.
And so am I. And don't hang around hoping to see Peter Lawford. Go on home.
Yes, sir.
Peter Lawford is coming here?
Oh, yes. I'm going to ask him to judge the Air Force Bathing Beauty Contest.
Oh, dear. How do I look?
Like Marilyn Monroe's double.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Yes.
Would you take my picture with him?
Of course. No, wait a minute. No, he'll be coming direct from the golf course today. I don't think he'll want to pose for a picture.
Why not?
Well, he won't have his makeup and other equipment. It's very windy on the golf course, you know. Oh, now, Florence, come. You've been around. You know what goes on behind the scenes in Hollywood.
Oh, yes, of course. What?
The tricks that they use to make our favorite stars look like people, stars.
You mean Peter Lawford doesn't look as handsome and rugged on the golf course as he does on the screen?
Well, Schulze, as per ordered, one Peter Lawford.
Martha, will you please give me back my glasses?
Peter Lawford doesn't wear any glasses.
He does around here. And take off the scalp doily.
Then I won't look like Peter Lawford.
That's the way the boss wants you.
Honey, you don't need any props. You can do it on sheer talent.
You think so?
Sure. Think Peter Lawford.
Talk to me, baby.
Project Peter Lawford. And you'll be Peter Lawford.
I'm definitely third. I'm Peter Lawford.
Good. Now sell me.
I hate to bother you, boss, but Peter Lawford's here.
Oh, yes, send Shorty in.
Shorty?
Peter, I'm so used to seeing him without his elevator shoes.
You mean he's not really tall and broad-shouldered?
Oh, Florence, I'm so sorry to keep disillusioning you like this. He's probably not nearly as bad as I make him.
Oh, yes, he is.
Cheer up. Nice you could make it, Shorty, old boy. Shake hands with Mrs. Batterson. She's a real Peter Lawford fan.
Oh, is she really?
Yes.
Oh, jolly good to know you and all that sort of rot.
How do you do?
We must go punting on the Thames one day. You bring the football. Let me use the prop.
Yes, okay. This is the word I was telling you about, you see.
Definitely. Yes, yes,
but
Shorty.
He still doesn't look like Peter Lawford.
Oh, but with the makeup and the putty, he could do much better, you see.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'll put makeup.
We'll be in touch with you.
I'll yes. put makeup. Clothes. I'll come back.
Don't call. We'll call you.
How'd it go, doll?
I laid a bomb. I gotta meet Peter Lawford and study him, that's all.
You're gonna meet him. You don't even know where he lives.
So I'll find out where he lives. That's hard. What, are you making me a dope or something? You're trying to make me a schnook or something?
I make you like a schnook. Mother Nature beat me to it.
Oh, you're no Bridget Bardot, you know.
What are you starting
I can
again?
Imitate Come anybody. On. Listen, sir, will you say something, please?
Hello there.
Hello there.
Not even close.
Hold it! Don't call me what's
Hello, Schultze.
Hi.
All my pictures here?
Who cares? You are. Yeah. I was gonna bring them out to your house.
Oh, Schultze, if an attractive girl like you came to my house, my wife Pat would be very jealous.
Oh, say that again.
My wife Pat would be very
jealous. First part.
An attractive girl like you.
Once more.
An attractive, adorable girl like you.
In French.
Oh, come on, Schultze, we're
Oh, the color shots are in the dark room. Would you care to join me?
Well, I'm afraid of the dark. Why don't you get them?
Please, Mr. Collins.
Get the phone. Will you show this, please?
Please. Say you'll judge the contest for us.
Well, if you'd prefer me to Shorty.
Peter Lawford?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, it's better with the elevators, but the putty and makeup didn't help one bit. Hair.
Wow.
I'll see you on the judges' stand.
Yeah, goodbye, Mrs. and Mrs. Hi there, Pete. What's new?
She is. Oh. You've got some pretty weird characters around the studio.
Well, she's the only one.
Well, Collins incarcerated me in the dark room. Stinker.
See, Pete, in any business, you're liable to run into one oddball now and then.
I see you kept your promise and got me Peter Lawford. Otherwise, Mr. Collins, I would be absolutely furious. Come, Mr. Lawford.
Where are we going?
We're going grinding hunting.
In that
A discovery of importance to smokers. It's yours today in Salem Cigarettes. The news is just broken. Salem Research has now developed an entirely new kind of cigarette paper, high porosity paper that air softens every puff. Through the invisible porous openings along the entire length, just the right amount of fresh air blends with each puff to give you a softer, fresher, more flavorful smoke than ever. Menthol Fresh, rich tobacco taste. Modern filter, too. That's Salem. And now even the paper adds to Salem's springtime freshness. Now exclusive high porosity paper, air softens the smoke. If you haven't tried Salem, buy a pack or a carton today. Smoke refreshed. Smoke Salem. More than ever, Salem refreshes your taste. Martha Randolph was played by Rose Marie, Roscoe DeWitt by Sidney Miller, Pamela Livingstone by Nancy Culp, Mrs. Batterson by Madge Blake, General Batterson by Robert Burton, and Harriet Wilde by Dorothy Johnson. This is Bill Baldwin speaking. The Cummings Show has been brought to you by Winston, the easy-drawing filter cigarette that really tastes like a cigarette.
Yes, friends, Winston tastes good, like a cigarette should.